A wagon filled with sand has a hole so that the sand leaks to it at a constant rate of lambda. An external force F acts on the wagon in the direction of the motion. Assuming instantaneous velocity of the wagon to be V vector and initial mass to be M naught, the force equation governing the motion of the wagon will be equal to. Now, first of all, assume that this is a wagon, okay, of initial mass M naught, and after a certain time, let its mass be equal to M. Okay, let its mass be equal to M. There is a force which acts in this direction. There is sandbag there is a hole at the bottom which gives the sand at a rate of lambda over here. Okay, we have to calculate the equation of the force in this direction. Okay, and at any point the velocity is equal to V vector. Okay, first of all understand that the force which acts in the forward direction, that since there is no frictional force, it will be equal to dP vector divided by dt. Okay, it will be equal to dP vector divided by dt. Now dP, the P vector can be written as M into V vector, where the M and V both are variable. Even the mass is changing, even the velocity is changing. So I can write this part as M dV vector divided by dt plus V vector dm by dt. Okay. Now over here, understand that it will be equal to, since the mass, now the V vector dV vector divided by dt, I will keep this part as it is. Okay, over here if I consider the velocity, okay, dm by dt is given as lambda, because over here the lambda over here will be equal to dm divided by dt, that is the mass that has been, okay, the mass that has been leaked from the wagon. Okay, so it will be equal to V vector, okay, into it will be equal to V vector into lambda. Okay, it will be V vector into lambda. Okay, now let us write down, if you see over here, we have to convert this mass. Okay, now since this mass is falling constantly, okay, lambda is equal to dm by dt, so it will be equal to, dm will be equal to lambda into dt. Okay, lambda into dt. So when I integrate on both the sides, dm will be equal to, let the initial mass be equal to, let the final mass be over here m, let the initial mass be equal to m naught. So it will be m minus m naught, it will be equal to lambda into t. Okay, it will be lambda into t. Okay, now since the mass is declining, I can write this as minus lambda into t. Okay, so basically m will be equal to m naught minus lambda t. Okay, m will be equal to m naught minus lambda t. Okay, so I can write this part as m naught minus lambda t dv vector divided by dt plus v vector into lambda. Okay, if you consider this part also, dm by dt, it should also be equal to minus lambda. But since I can only see one option over here, which is option number D, which gives somewhat this answer, it will be equal to V vector into lambda. Okay, V vector into lambda. So the correct answer is option number D.